Today, I will talk about how to test the DC inverter air conditioner compressor. And I will tell you the complete procedure of testing the DC compressor. And what does a bad compressor looks like? I will tell you all these things. Let's move to the demonstration. As you can see, I have placed these things on the table. This is a multimeter, through which I will tell you how to test the compressor, and other than this, I will tell you how to check the PCB and how you will estimate whether the fault is in the compressor or the PCB has the problem. And this I will tell you through the bulbs and this tester in the next video. But today, I will demonstrate how to test the inverter compressor through the multimeter. This is the outdoor unit of inverter AC on which I will tell you how to test the DC compressor. Friends, before testing the compressor, you have to disconnect the connector attaching the compressor and the PCB. And the other model, inverter AC PCB, has no such connector. And the PCB wires are directly attached to the terminals of the compressor. Then you will have to disconnect those wires from the terminals, so you can separate the PCB from the compressor. And this test will be done after separating the compressor from the PCB. And the compressor could not be tested with the PCB attached. Take a multimeter, and set it to ohms. After this, attach the probes of the multimeter to compressor terminals. Attach the first probe to any terminal of the compressor and the second probe to the next terminal. And see, the multimeter has started showing us the compressor's reading. So we are getting the value of 1.2 ohms on the multimeter with these two terminals. Note down this value. Next, attach any one probe of the multimeter to the next terminal of the compressor. See, the multimeter is showing the value again, which is the same 1.3 ohms. Remove the black probe of the multimeter and attach it to the center of the connector for the compressor. So the multimeter shows a 1.5 ohms reading, but it has adjusted the value to 1.2 ohms, which is the same as previous readings. All the values of the compressor terminal should be the same. If the reading difference is in points, no problem. The reading should not rise to 3, 4, or 5 ohms. Instead, it should be near the value of 1.2 ohms. Now it means that the value is correct for the compressor. And the compressor winding is electrically in good condition. Now let me tell you about the next test. Now the next test for the inverter compressor is significant. You have to check the compressor's leakage and whether the compressor's winding has any leakage present in it or not. You have to attach any probe of the multimeter with the compressor terminal connector. And attach the second probe of the multimeter with the copper pipe, which should be welded with the compressor. See, the multimeter is showing no reading. Same, attach the red probe of the multimeter with the next terminal of the compressor. And check the compressor leakage. It also has no reading. In the same way, I checked the third terminal as well. It means that the winding of the compressor is fine and has no leakage or body short inside the compressor. This way, your compressor will be said to be in good condition. Now I will show you that compressor which is body short. And let's see how it will seem to be. This is another compressor. And let me show you what the body short will seem like. It has no connector in this one, as I told you before. I have removed its PCB, and these are its three terminals on the top. Again, set the multimeter on ohms. And attach any one probe of the multimeter with the terminal of the compressor. And when we touch the second probe with the pipe body, so the multimeter is showing us a reading. See, its winding has been leaked and shorted. Now I will remove the probe from the terminal we checked to the next one. Still, the body short is present. If you check it on one terminal, you will know the short of the compressor, but I will also show you the last terminal. See, it is the same on this one as well. That means this compressor is completely bad. And if you attach this compressor with the PCB can get damaged. So friends, this is for today's video. I will catch you up in the next one. Watch next video by clicking on the left or right of the screen. Thank you.